Hello, everyone, and welcome to The Guy Dawson Show at WCOBM.com, the World Center of Broadcast Media, live from the Gene Woods Racing Experience in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. My name is Guy Dawson, and I am the managing member of Classic Communications, a full-service public relations and advertising firm. And we bring greater recognition to businesses, individuals, and organizations. If you would like more information about how to gain recognition through free media, please get in contact with me at 702-845-6129 or visit our website, classycommunications.net. I have two lovely ladies surrounding me again this week. I always telling Quan, that's why I got into show business, Quan, so I can hang out with the beautiful women all the time.
Lucky Aww. Guy. What a lucky guy. I mean, the whole world is jealous. Hi, guys.
Yeah, the illustrious Quan is back for another week of the Guy Dawson Show. How have you been?
Being fabulous.
Oh, really? Yeah. That good?
Every day. Every day, some new challenges and learning something, make a small baby steps progress.
That's right. What'd you learn this week?
Learn a couple of English words.
Really? Illustrious. Did you look it up like I asked?
I call her
the illustrious Quan, and one of her homework assignments was to...
I'm confused with delicious food.
Delicious food.
That's why I said to Google it. Google illustrious, and then you'll get the definition of it.
Yeah.
You got to be the teacher. Spell it clearly.
I forgot to give Quan the spelling, so that's why you didn't get your homework done.
That's funny. Wow.
Maybe next time homework. Quiz first.
Well, I better write it out, and I'm so happy to have you back for another edition of the Guy Dawson Show.
And the Mandarin class too.
I don't have any notes here to cheat on like I do on radio.
And then Renee, you'll be on the Mandarin class together with
see?
Guy.
Yeah, but please don't ask.
Our roving reporter Renee Adams is back in the studio
the
to talk about
reporter.
The upcoming events that she's going to be involved in. Welcome back, Renee.
Thank you. I'm so excited. Yay! I'm so excited to be here on the Guy Dawson Show. All the exciting things that's happening in September. You know, as your Las Vegas reporter, Renee Adams, I am so excited. Please find me on Facebook as well, Renee Adams, blue dress, beautiful. But I am so excited, Guy, and I'm excited to be here on the show with Quan and you to be able to share all that great news.
Yeah, Renee is the roving reporter of the WCOBM, and there's a lot in store.
It is a lot in store.
What have you been up to?
What I've been up to, oh my gosh, that is the question of the day, right? There has been so many opportunities to be able to bring to WCOBM. And one thing that I wanted to bring up is Floyd Mayweather, that fight, because that's coming up September 12th.
Oh, are you covering that
right
fight?
Soon.
Well, hopefully. I mean, I'm keeping my fingers crossed on that.
Right.
You know, I am keeping my fingers crossed. I'm just a little fish in a big pond, but I'm hoping that I can get somewhere with that. But that's coming up, and I'm really excited about, you know, just the fight and that being the last fight of his career. I don't know if that's really true, but we'll see. I mean, he's 48-0. And that's
I think he'll be 50. I know he's saying that he'll retire at 49-0, but I think there's going to be too much money. Floyd likes money too much to pass on that 50th fight.
Yeah, he might as well make it 5-0. I mean, not 5-0, but 5-0.
Yeah, he will be doing
that. Would be awesome.
I mean, I would bet a lot of money. If I was a betting man, I would bet a lot of money that Floyd Mayweather will fight to get for that 50th.
Yeah.
Assuming that he wins the next fight, but he should.
But is it, okay, this might be a weird question, but he's fighting Andre Berto, and he's an African-American. Is that the first African-American that he's fought?
Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
No,
I was just wondering, or maybe just not recently he hasn't fought anybody. So I'm like...
Yeah, you know, the way that they arrange these fights, is it's cultural because it's all about the gate. It's about how much money they can generate from, and it's sometimes it's a cultural thing. So you match with certain cultures so that you can bring in the most money.
No,
and
that's why, true.
Like he fought Manny Pacquiao.
Absolutely.
And he's fought some Spanish fighters.
Right.
And it's all because of the amount of money they can make on pay-per-view and the gate and all that, a lot of times is tied to nationality.
Got it. Very good. Okay. Because I'm like, that's the last fight with Andre Berto. And I just noticed the picture yesterday when I was looking up the fight. And I was like, oh, I didn't even know. So that's... Hey, it's good.
How exciting.
Good. Wish
you guys have a great opportunity.
Yeah, and that's September 12th. So you know it's so going to be a lot of events going on September 12th just with the fight alone. But, you know, with that and the other things that's coming about, September is going to be huge, like huge, really big. So, like, the iHeartRadio is going to be here. And, you know,
who's coming? Do you know who's coming this year?
You know what? I don't have the list, but there is going to be, for example, Trey Songz, for one.
Oh, really?
But there's going to be, like, a whole lot of, like, really, you know, big artists that's going to be at the iHeartRadio. And then the Las Vegas Jazz Festival is going to be here as well.
Mm-hmm.
And wow. I do have a few people that's going to be at the Henderson Pavilion September 25th through the 27th. And that's Erykah Badu, Music, Soulchild, Toni Braxton, which is my favorite, and Brian McKnight, and so many more that's going to be there. And then Life is Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Same weekend, as Snoop Dogg is going to be there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Kendrick Lamar.
I saw Kanye West was there last year.
Oh, yeah. So it's going to be a lot of people. Kendrick Lamar, Duran. That's going to be on Fremont Street.
Duran,
yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Those guys?
Oh my gosh, and much more.
Huh?
Yeah, it's going to be really, really exciting. I'm like, oh my gosh, and it's my birthday weekend. Yay!
Yeah, Life is Beautiful. You know, I love what they've done with Fremont. Fremont Street and putting that event on.
Yeah.
I think of that. That's very smart. The way
it
that
was.
They created this event to get people to come into Vegas
right there.
And be downtown. It's been a real boost to our city creating
yes.
that event.
Yeah, it's going to be kind of like the EDC kind of crowd. Like
mm-hmm.
that, not the, I'm not,
not
saying
size.
The cultural,
yeah.
you know, aspect. I'm talking about just the big, you know, like that kind of crowd, like having a huge, crowd. But then also I'm bringing this one up because this one I think is going to be really good for different women that's looking to do different things with the Las Vegas Southwestern Women's Expo. So that's going to be pretty cool because
is that the 19th September?
That's
19th?
Going to be September 19th mm-hmm. through the 20th at the Cashman Convention Center, and there's going to be prominent speakers there, celebrity appearances, beauty makeovers. One in particular is going to be Sephora, which is one of their big sponsors, and prize giveaways, including a cruise giveaway and relaxing facials and much more on that end too. So it's going to be really exciting for that event if you can attend that. But like I said, there's so many things to choose from. You just have to try to go to all of them. I can't just say just go to one or a few. Go to every one, every single one of those. It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, yeah. Renee truly is the roving reporter. Boy, you're going to have a lot going on in September.
A lot of going and a lot of fun.
Well, yeah. Your calendar will be full. Oh my gosh, you need an extension page for all
that's
the
right,
events.
That's right.
And not to mention, like I was talking to her about, we have Las Vegas's largest mixer is also going to be coming up on September the 12th.
Absolutely.
Which is a huge event.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, on the business side, because I get wrapped up with those types of things, we're going to be doing a live broadcast of the PR Connections radio show out there. And
that's
going to
be exciting.
Huge event.
Absolutely.
At the Tuscany.
Yeah.
And so
how
that's
many people
another
about?
Thing. About 2,000.
Yeah, there you go.
About 2,000 people in the Tuscany.
Yeah.
About, I think it's 150 exhibitors.
Ooh, that's nice. Very
and
nice.
Mentioning the 3rd
the 16th,
of September.
By the way. Not the 16th. Not the 12th, but September the 16th.
Oh, okay.
And
then
the 3rd of September, Gene Wood in here, racetrack here.
Yeah, next Thursday we're throwing a party out here for the launch of the Guy Dawson Show. So these are
exciting.
Some very, very busy times for everyone.
Absolutely, yeah.
With
that's
free
be good.
Food.
Yeah, right, yeah.
That should be mentioned.
Po' Boy Streetcar Restaurant, which is a Creole restaurant here in town, is going to be providing food. We're going to have jambalaya, gumbo, cornbread. It's going to be a very, it's going to be a great event. It's very community oriented.
Yeah.
Half price on go-kart rides.
That
yeah,
sounds fun.
Bring
right.
your kids, bring your grandkids. Just it's going to be a very community-oriented event, and we just want everyone to have a good time, a late summer event where everyone from 6 o'clock to 9 o'clock on September the 3rd.
Here. And that's exciting. Yeah,
so
it should be more of those.
Can they bring dogs?
There will be dogs.
Maybe not, but can people bring their own dogs?
Well, there will be dogs here, so I guess pretty much anybody can bring a dog. Hearts Alive Village, which is a nonprofit organization that my company does a lot of things with, will also be here. There are going to be dogs in go-karts.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
No way.
Yeah. Let's
and on that note, we will head to a commercial break. We'll come back and tell you more about the driving dogs in the go-karts.
What's
See you in a few minutes with more of the Guy Dawson Show. Oh, my God.